Thanks for coming.
No problem.
Listen, Johnny, I like you. I think you're a decent guy. You're a little off-center, but you're not evil.
Oh, that's gratifying.
Lisa Niles, on the other hand, is evil. And she's crazy. But I want to know how long you plan on trying to protect her.
It seems like we've had this conversation before. You accuse me of hiding a needle for Lisa. I don't know anything more this time than when the last time you spoke.
Okay, well, let me help jog your memory. While my wife is lying helpless in a hospital bed, barely surviving a house fire, Lisa comes in and tries to drug her. Robin catches her. She runs out, bumps into you, asks you for help.
Refresh my memory again as to what my motive might be, why I would want to help Lisa.
You scratch her back, she scratches yours. It's that simple.
That's quite an assumption.
Well, it's no assumption what you do for a living, Johnny. And somewhere along the line, you had an accident. It needed medical expertise. You didn't want to garner the extra attention by going to the emergency room, so you asked Lisa for help.
Right, it's all coming back to me now. Lisa is this psychotic stalker, but you didn't realize that until after you slept with her, of course.
Lisa is crazy. Not only is she trying to ruin Robin's reputation and career, she's come dangerously close to killing her and my daughter.
I don't suppose you have anything resembling proof.
Johnny, you have the proof. All I want is Lisa to stop terrorizing my family.
Wow, that's all very dramatic. Kind of makes me a bastard for not offering to help out. Except, I really don't see much terror going on. All I see is you trying to pin everything on Lisa.
I don't understand how you don't get this. You are the key to my family's safety. I need you to help me. Let me ask you something. Do you think I invented this long list of crimes that Lisa committed against my wife?
I think there's a long list of incidents that are open for interpretation.
You have the one piece of evidence that exists, Johnny. You give me the syringe and I'll make it worth your while.
You do realize I have all the money I could want.
Well, I'm a better doctor than Lisa. Whatever medical services she's providing, I'll improve on it. No questions asked. You can tell yourself that you did the right thing.
Why is supporting you automatically the right thing? And why is liking Lisa automatically wrong? Seems like it's all based on perspective, right? Turns out, mine's just different than yours.
Excuse me, doctor, in a moment of your time? Okay, sign out and go straight to your hotel room.
Now, why would I go all the way to the Metro Court when I have a perfectly good on-call room right here?
Okay, just go there. Don't run any errands, don't get any food in the restaurant, and just wait in your room. You won't be sorry. Hi, what room is Terrell Jackson in?
You can use the house phone to call Dr. Jackson. I'm not allowed to give out that information.
I'm Dr. Niles. It's an emergency. Maybe you can make an exception?
If you were to guess room 581, that would be a good guess.
Thank you. You're such a doll. When Robin Scorpio Drake comes to see her husband, tell her that he's been moved to room 581.
Well, oh. Dr. Niles here for another stay at the Metro Court?
Yeah, I was thinking about treating myself to some spa treatments, room service. Yeah, Metro Court has a lot to offer.
But you know that.
Okay, I have done all my rounds, put my patients to bed. I'm out of here.
Oh, not so fast, Doctor. Drake Jr. left the case for you to take a look at.
Well, a little notice would have been nice. This patient's having surgery at 7 in the morning tomorrow.
Well, Drake Jr. already left.
Of course. He expects me to drop everything and show up at his hotel room.
Oh, don't look at me. It is not my job. I just pass along the information.
I didn't stop to eat, just like you said. I came straight to room 581. Ordered a nice bottle of red that'll keep you all kinds of warm inside. And porterhouse steaks, medium rare. The only thing missing from this room is you. So don't keep me waiting. Steak could get cold.
Excuse me. Could you please call my husband's room, Dr. Patrick Drake, and let him know that I'm here?
You're Dr. Scorpio Drake, right? Dr. Drake has been moved to room 581. He's expecting you.
Okay, thank you. Thank you so much. I really appreciate it. One more thing. Call this number and tell Patrick Drake that his wife needs him to go to room 581 right away.
I think I've seen this movie before.
Perfect timing. Wine is breathing.